Hi, meet Sarah. She is a young woman who started experiencing episodes of confusion, staring, unresponsiveness. She was worried about these events, and then she met a neurologist who was investigated these events and ordered an EEG test to understand what is going on in her brain. So if you wonder what is an EEG test, what does it show, who needs it, and all of this important information about the test, then you are in the right place. I will tell you also at the end of the video a bonus point on how to understand the language of the doctors when you are reading an EEG report. Welcome to the Epilepsy Encyclopedia. I'm your epilepsy neurologist, Dr. Omar Danoun. So what is an EEG test? So an EEG test is a test that detects the brain waves and brain activity by placing a small wires on the skin on the head, and that can detect the brain cell activity. So the brain cells communicate in between each other using electricity, and this can be detected by an EEG test. And through that test, we can tell what is normal brain activity and what is abnormal or epileptic brain activity. So why someone would need an EEG test? So there are multiple indications or reasons why we do an EEG test. We might be investigating for episode like staring or concern about seizures. Also, we can use the EEG to detect any abnormal sleep issues. Also, we can understand the brain function and even do research and understand the neuroscience research of the brain. And we can monitor the brain function during a procedure or a surgery or even in the intensive care unit. So what are the types of EEG? There are different types of EEG, depends on the length and the reason why we're doing the test. The first one, which is the standard EEG or routine EEG, usually it is anywhere between 20 minutes to 40 minutes, and it can be done in an office setting, and this is the standard EEG. Other EEGs can be prolonged EEG or long-term video EEG. This test is usually done in a hospital setting when the patient is admitted in the hospital, stays for multiple days, and we can also reduce the anti-seizure medications and study the brain activity and seizures in depth to know what type of epilepsy we're treating, where the seizures are coming from, or even prepare for surgical treatment if needed. And we prefer to do it in the hospital to be able to monitor the patient with video and EEG, to be able to test the patient when they have events, also to be able to induce seizures in a safe environment. The other type is called ambulatory EEG, when you can get the EEG leads and be at your home. So either the company will send somebody to your house to connect the leads, or you get it in the hospital and go home. So we can monitor the patient in their own environment, and we can have a camera attached and then report all these changes. However, in this setting, we cannot intervene, we cannot assist the patient, and we cannot safely reduce anti-seizure medications. And there is a new type of EEG called spot EEG, which is a band or a wire or a helmet that can be applied on the spot in the emergency department quickly when we don't have the facilities or the resources to do a longer a formal EEG. So these spot EEGs can be handy in cases of emergency. And the latest type of EEG is the subscalp long-term EEG. This is a new technology that is being utilized when they implant a small leads of EEG, usually in the subscalp in the right side and left side, and especially like the temporal lobe seizures, and can record for weeks or even months of time. And then this can help us to understand how many seizures are happening from each side of the brain on the long term. So how is the EEG done? So when you have the EEG test, you will come to the center or to the clinic that does the EEG. You will be comfortably seated. The head will be cleaned up, and then we'll be applying the electrodes, the wires, with sometimes gel, and sometimes it can be with collodion, which is kind of like super glue to keep it stuck on the head for longer EEG. And then you will sit quietly, relax. You might be asked to breathe fast or be exposed to flashing lights. All these are to detect the brain reaction to these stimulation procedures. And then for longer tests, you might be asked to sleep during the test, which I prefer, honestly, because if you sleep during the EEG test, that increases the chances of capturing anything abnormal, because the epileptic activity tend to sneak out in sleep states. So it's very, very important to be able to sleep. And sometimes we do sleep-deprived EEG when we ask the patient to not sleep the night before. Usually we ask them like to wake up early at 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, so that they can sleep during the test. And for children, make sure that you keep them tired and then they do not sleep on the way to the hospital. So if you have an EEG, how to prepare for an EEG test? There are a few steps you can do to prepare for the EEG test. First, make sure that your hair is clean, nothing on your head or hair like weaves or anything that can be stuck on your scalp. Do not apply anything on the hair like hair products, because that can affect the quality of the test. And be prepared to be able to get relaxed and sleep during the test. And as we said, we can have sleep deprivation, which is waking up at 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning to be able to sleep during the test. So what are the risks of an EEG? EEG is generally a very safe procedure. It is just a test that detects the brain activity. However, there are small chances of a reaction to the material we use, the gel or the scrubbing material. It can irritate the scalp, and in very rare cases, they can have an allergy to that. But what concerns me in the test is that the interpretation of the EEG. So when you interpreted the EEG, the doctors will read it. Hopefully the doctor has a good training in EEG and read it correctly, because the most dangerous thing about EEG, if it is read incorrectly, that will lead to the wrong diagnosis. So what does the EEG test show? So the EEG can show multiple things. First, it can show the normal brain activity, normal wakefulness, and normal sleep. It can show epileptic activity, which are, we call them sharp waves or spikes. These are abnormal electricity in the brain consistent with the diagnosis of epilepsy. Also, it can have some focal changes, which means like things that happen inside the brain, one area is not working properly or so, it can also show on the EEG test. So how do we interpret the EEG test? So the EEG test has lots of valuable information that can be extracted, and it can tell us if somebody has epilepsy or not. It can see the seizures, can exclude that diagnosis, and so on. Also, it can guide the epilepsy treatment. However, we should understand that EEG can be positive in epilepsy, but also it can be negative, which means that it does not show any epileptic activity in patients with epilepsy and they're having seizures. This is like you're looking at a street and you looked for 30 minutes and no cars passed during that time. That does not mean that this street never has cars whatsoever. Sometimes the epileptic activity can be deep, can be small, or can be rare. It does not happen all the time. So you saw the EEG for like an hour or two and did not happen that time. So what we do to get better results, we do it with sleep, we do it with a longer EEG, or we repeat the test multiple times. And as we said, it is very, very important who reads the EEG, because the EEG is a very delicate test and it needs high experience and expertise and extra training to be able to read the EEG correctly and call things what they are. The most common issue is that people will read the EEG without extensive experience or dedicated training, and they start calling everything epileptic activity when the patient does not have epilepsy. So if you want to be directly evaluated by myself, we have the availability now to do a one-on-one consultation when I can check all the testing and give you the best treatment plan. So check out the link in the description below for more information. Okay, so if we are doing an EEG and having a treatment, how often we need to repeat the EEG? So the EEG is a test that tells us the brain activity. So repeating the test is not indicated in all the patients. So there is a mistake that some doctors will do every visit there is an EEG test done. So that is not indicated. So what we do, we use it to guide the treatment. So if somebody has no seizures, the seizures are stable, we don't need to repeat the EEG. If somebody has seizures that came back after being dormant for a long time, then maybe an EEG can help us. If we are giving treatment and the EEG was very, very active before, then an a follow-up EEG can help. But we don't have to do EEG in every single visit. All right, so what does an EEG report mean? There are multiple words that the doctors will put in their EEG report. So the first one is normal. Normal, you know, that's the easy one, that normal EEG did not show epileptic activity. That does not rule out epilepsy. As I said, maybe 50% or more of people will have normal EEG despite having epilepsy. Other things, it can be epileptic activity. The buzzword for the epileptic activity is sharp and slow waves, or spike and slow wave, generalized spike and wave discharges. All these words mean that there is epilepsy activity, excess electricity, buzz in the brain, and that indicates that somebody has epilepsy. And if it is focal epilepsy or generalized epilepsy, it can be by the discharge. Is it focal discharge or generalized discharge? So this means that you have epilepsy diagnosis based on the results. Also, it can show slowness. Slowness means the brain should run maybe like at frequency of 9 or 10, alpha wave we call it. If the brain is running at slower pace, means like they're running at 8, 7, 6, 4 or some slower, then that can be an issue. Usually we call it encephalopathy, means like sick brain. It can be from infection, from metabolic issues, or many other things that make the brain sick or slow. Other findings can be focal dysfunction, which means that we have an area, maybe a temporal lobe or something, that has slowness in it. The activity is not fast enough, and that can reflect a lesion or a scar or something inside that area that made the area not work properly and caused slowness. I always ask you to talk to your doctor or the doctor who did the EEG and asked them to explain the report to you so that you can better understand it and know how it can change the management for your case. So the EEG is a vital test in the diagnosis of epilepsy, but there are other testing and other evaluation to make the diagnosis. And importantly, you need to learn how to treat epilepsy and make the correct diagnosis. And to do all of that, I have this video that in details explain how to diagnose epilepsy, what is the right treatment and right testing that you need to do. And see you in the next video. Salam.